Ladies and gentlemen, undoubtedly, a powerhouse in politics for several years in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Now he's back to ensure that we continue to do the good work for the ULP here in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Maxwell Charles built on his foundation. Now he is going to build on Maxwell's foundation. Put your hands together, raise those flags for Sir Louis Stryker, the Terminator. I'm back.
This morning, smile with the rising sun.
Mr. Chairman, thank you for raising it up. So it was a little too short for me. I am excited to be back home among our Labour supporters and be celebrating 14 years of victory and getting ready for the 15th year.
Me and my neighbor, voting for Labour.
Somebody say,
show me your voting finger. Raise up your voting finger. Show me your voting finger. Raise up the voting. All right.
Me and my neighbor,
voting for Labour.
Voting for Labour.
Me and my neighbor,
voting for Labour.
I can't help looking back beyond the beginning of the 14 years. When we stood in the trenches at Camden Park Bridge at first, and then near Dr. Cyrus Museum, when we were given the majority of votes and we couldn't form the government, René Baptiste, myself, Dr. Gerald Thompson, and Conrad Sears, and our supporters, we held firm. And we say we ain't moving any place. ODD said that we would work with them and we must change government. And we changed government in 2001. And now we are celebrating our 14th years. Thanks to the stalwart leadership of these people who stood in the trenches with us. I tell you, Central Leeward has been central in the planning of the ULP. And when the NDP thought they had government in 2008, they fooled themselves because they said Central Leeward is going to come over to us. But thank God, even though I was retired, we had a man who could have kept back the tide, and he brought home Central Leeward for the ULP. Maxwell, join me up here, please.
So give me some vibe. It's action when I come in, and eruption when I come in, destruction when I come in, from the border, the border. It's wind up when I come in, and wave up when I come in.
Now they think they can fish in troubled waters, and they think they can divide Maxwell, put a division between Maxwell and me, and between us and the people of Central Leeward. But the people of Central Leeward would remain firmly in the column of the Unity Labour Party comes the next general election. And that is based on solid accomplishment for Central Leeward. They brought back a blind young fella here. Who needs to go? We need to send him to Cuba under the Vision Now program, because he said he left here at 9 years of age. He spent 40 years in Canada, and since he's been away, he has come back, and there has been no progress in Central Leeward. So he needs to go to Cuba and cut his glaucoma. This party has been good to Central Leeward. We have the largest low-income housing project in all of St. Vincent. The one that they said we are putting people to live in Gugu Field. That is the Peter Sow project. We built two secondary schools, one at Peter Sow and one at Bookamend Bay for our young people. And under this government, that's part of the education revolution, bearing in mind that when we took over in 2001, only 39 students could have entered into secondary schools. And now everybody has access to secondary education. When the Prime Minister said we must have universal secondary education, they said we are putting people in boat school. What a disgrace to put them in boat school. Prime Minister told them they would go in boat school now, because grammar school at one time was a boat school. But we are going to build solid structures for them, and throughout the length and breadth of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, we have solid secondary schools, modern secondary schools with science labs and all the labs, language labs, that we can provide for our students. This is what we are celebrating now. My wife has taught for some 20-something years in the United States of America, and she was shocked to hear that this government was providing laptops, computers for every primary school student and every secondary school student. Not even the great United States of America could do that with students. This is what we are celebrating. We are celebrating when the Labour Party left. They were getting $50 in poor public assistance. After 17 years of the NDP, they increased it to $10, less than $1 per year. And now it is $220 in 10 years. This government has increased public assistance for the poor to $220 from $60.
Don't thank me. Thank the savings.
You can't skip this Geico ad because it's already over. Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
We've changed from Domino's Pizza to Domino's because we're more than pizza. Taste what else we have to offer and order any of our specialty chicken, pastas, sandwiches, or stuffed cheesy bread. Choose any two, including medium two-topping pizzas for just $5.99 each.
Love to jam. You see me. I'm a man.
And not only Central Leeward, I am so happy. It doesn't matter if anybody tapes me here tonight. I have good legal advice here from North Leeward, a young, brilliant lawyer, Carlos James, that we are going to work together to bring home North Leeward. And we have another one to my south, in South Leeward, another brilliant lawyer, Jomo Thomas, so they would stand by me and defend me in any court of law, so that we would bring home all three seats for the ULP. We have accomplished much during the past 14 years. Good governance. Do you realize that when we took over government, when you ask a question in parliament, you did not know in the public what the question was, because The previous government would say, question number five, standing in my name. So you never knew what question number five was. Parliament was never broadcast so that you could hear what is happening in your own parliament. And when it was done by Glenn Jackson in 2002, somewhere around there, before we got into power, the NDP went bazzardy and said, no, we don't want the people to know what is happening in parliament. It is this ULP government, like a breath of fresh air, open up the parliament so that everybody can see and everybody can hear what parliament is doing in the name of the people. That's good governance. And I tell you, ladies and gentlemen, we want to go forward. Great things are going to happen in the next 5 years. And that is why I have come out of retirement, because I have the mental and physical energy. I want to work with our young people like Jomo and like Carlos James and like Luke and like Saboto.
Like young Montgomery Daniel. And young Seth Mackey. Don't make the gray hair fool you. They're young at heart. I want to work with these people for the social and economic development of St. Vincent the Grenadines. How could I stay out when the biggest project in Central Leeward, the Mount Dwayne Peter Soap Resort, is likely to come on stream very soon, and we are going to sign a project, an agreement, that would bring jobs for all of our people on the Leeward end. How could I stay out? I want to be part of that. How could I stay out when an international airport would be open? I don't want to stay out. I want to be part of it so that we can make the international airport a success. I tell you the truth, I hear some foolish talk that they're saying, oh, if the Labour Party builds the international airport, we would finish it or we would manage it. And I ask them, if Arnim Eustace had the Peace Memorial Hall in his constituency and he allowed it to run down and couldn't do anything with it, $200,000 he could not provide to rehabilitate the Peace Memorial Hall, Ralph had to come in and do it for him in his constituency. How could he manage a big project like the international airport?
I'm too experienced to be taking for a stroll.
If we put our National Public Library upstairs of a Marby shop so that you might go back and forth and don't realize a National Library is upstairs there. He could not build a decent public library for our country. How could he build, how could he manage an international airport? And when you see the building we have there for the National Archives and Documentation Center and the Intermediate High School, all within his constituency, and he was Minister of Finance, he was Prime Minister, and he couldn't do it. He left it for Ralph to do it for him. Then I don't know how you can put confidence in a nincompoop like that to say he could be a Prime Minister. Comrades, when I see what we have ahead of us, the big project, renewable energy, we are going to bring that on stream so that you could have cheaper electric bills. I want to be part of that in the future. That could not be done by the NDP. It can only be done with people with a lot of gray matter, a lot of brains. And these are the people that would be leading this government when the elections come in December or March.
I'm searching for a victory.
tell you, we are going to have some exciting days ahead. We are still going to lead the charge in terms of regional and international integration so that we can have all of our people moving back and forth. We can have a bigger market. We can attract investment from within the region to come to St. Vincent and provide greater amount of jobs for our people here. That's what we're going to do in the next 5 years, and that's what I want to be a part of. You have children, you have grandchildren, and the Prime Minister has said that by the year 2030, he wants every home to have a university graduate. When we took over, there were just four teachers in the primary school system with a degree. Under this administration, we have approximately 400 teachers who have been able to get degrees.
Over 600, no.
Sorry, the Prime Minister has corrected me. Over 600 primary school teachers that have degrees. Thanks to this government, if the NDP was in power, we would have still had about a dozen and no more in the primary school system with a degree. Many of you, the older ones, might never have been to a university, and you probably could not have given the name of one or two universities. But in the far-flung corners of the world, in Russia, in the Dominican Republic, in Taiwan, in Cuba, in India, you name it, we have our sons and our daughters studying there, learning foreign languages, and coming home with degrees. And when I hear some of them say, oh, they're coming back with degrees, but that is no good because they can't find jobs. And I ask them, is it better that they remain in ignorance, or they get the education and they can come back here and go throughout the region or anywhere in the world and have a job because they have the qualification? Under this government, the middle class and the upper class people could have enjoyed sending their children to the nursing school, and we were able to graduate just a few nurses, in so much that when we came in power, we had to ask Cuba to lend us 22 nurses. And this government said this is not good enough. And we said we would open the floodgates if even we have to pay our students to go to nursing school. When they come out, they can go to the far-flung corners of the world because nurses are in need all over the world. And now, everybody has a chance to go to the nursing school. When I came back here, we had about 4 nurses in Leyu. We had about 5 in Barili. Now we have about 36 nurses from my constituency because of the nursing program. And the same thing is happening to policemen. Our policemen were going to St. Kitts, going to Bermuda, going to Turks and Caicos because they started them with $900 a year. The Prime Minister said, no, that's not good enough. We want to keep our best men here. And now a policeman would start with something close to $1,700 a month, thanks to this government. And that's the government I want to be a part of. And I ask you, ladies and gentlemen, let us hold hands and let us fight for our country, our children, and our grandchildren. We want to make this a better St. Vincent. I am not in this for the money. I was making maybe 4 times this as a banker in New York. But I love my people. I love my constituency. I love my country, and I have come back to give service. And if it means that I have to do it out of retirement and I come back, I would do it again and again. And thank God, with your support, we are going to form the next government and keep the progress going for our country and our children. God bless you and good night.